Let's catch up with the Shadow Treasurer, Angus Taylor, now joining me live from Goulburn. Thanks for joining us, Angus. Let's get to inflation first up. The number is low, the headline figure in the target. Will the Reserve Bank be tempted to lower interest rates within the next couple of months?
Well, thanks for having me, Chris. But the truth is that you won't hoodwink the Reserve Bank with a temporary subsidy. They'll look straight through this. We know this because they've already said it. They're not going to take that into account. And when you look at the underlying measures, when you look beneath the bonnet, there is still a long way to go to get back to a strong, growing, low inflation economy. We see services inflation, which is a really critical measure for the Reserve Bank, still well above 4%. Non-tradable inflation, that's the homegrown inflation, again, above 4%. We're well outside of the target. We're also at the back of the pack in dealing with this core inflation. And we're at the back of the pack in terms of interest rates coming down. They've come down in Europe, they've come down in the United States, in the UK, in the UK, in Canada, in New Zealand, not in Australia. We have a long way to go here, and the Reserve Bank, as I say, won't be hoodwinked. And as you rightly say, Chris, what we will see when these temporary subsidies come off is a big surge in electricity prices. We know that the underlying electricity prices since Labor came to power have gone up by 33%. And that's a huge hit to Australians. But the price of everything else has also gone up. Prices aren't coming down. There's none of that in sight. And we've got a long way to go before we have a real relief in terms of inflation and interest rates.